Sounding like this is Summer from Yanzu's, and today we will discuss about the side determination of the humerus bone. This bone is of the arm, that is, it is between the elbow and the shoulder joint. Okay, now let's come towards video. Okay, so now for determination of side, always remember there is a tubercle on the anterior side here, and also another tubercle. So this one is known as greater tubercle of the humerus, and this one is known as lesser tubercle of the humerus, and between them is a bicipital groove. Okay, when finding anatomical position of the humerus, always remember that this head is projected upward, slightly backward, and on the medial side. Okay, and the greater tubercle lies on the anterior side of the humerus. Okay, so for the low end, you see there is a small fossa which is known as conoid fossa, and on the posterior aspect there is a large fossa which is known as olecranon fossa, where the olecranon process of the ulna articulate here. It fit into it, and so always remember, on the posterior aspect there lies olecranon fossa. This is a large fossa, and on the anterior side there is a small fossa. Okay, so greater tubercle on the anterior side and olecranon fossa on the posterior side. Okay, the head is directly medially, so this is of the left side. Okay, why not right side? If I put it here, you see head medially, but there is no tubercle on the anterior side. The greater tubercle lies on the posterior side. So side determination goes wrong. So we can say that this is of left side. Greater tubercle on the anterior aspect. And you see here the small fossa on the anterior side, and on the backward there is olecranon fossa. Also, this is known as trochlea and capitulum. This process, trochlea lies medially and capitulum lies laterally. But I have already mentioned this one. Always remember, this lies on the posterior side of the humerus. So you can easily remember. So you can easily check whether it is of right side or of left side. Hope you get it. Jazakallah for watching.